VP Wase, it's been a good week. I don't know how your week has been, but for me, my week was great. Looking forward for today, 5th of December 2020. Sema mwaka kuja kuisha. How else can we enjoy this wonderful month apart from enjoying a wonderful, smooth, and entertaining conversation here at Wema Online TV with me, Big Ed, only on Dialogue at the Well, each and every Saturday. Tunajuanga ni saa ngapi? Kama K, kama Kawa, 6 p.m. And with me today, sema leo. Leo tuko na ule mse. He's no longer a guest in this show, but he's part of Dialogue at the Well community. Welcome, Mr. Prince Negwa, my brother.
Thank you, sir.
Iyo zito lazima isikike. Karibu sana, bana.
Kabisa, kabisa.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, niambia bana.
Niko poa. I'm glad to be back.
Wiki imekuaje?
It has been nice. Uh-huh. It has been great. Uh-huh. Tumekanyaga December bana.
By the grace of God. Huku ndani. Well, December inakupelekaje? Naifilaje?
In December, we are glad that we are finally here. By all means. Hata yes. Kama tulipitia. Finally tumefika bana.
Karibu sana.
The grace has been so sufficient.
Exactly.
And we thank him for everything.
Karibu sana. Last week atukua na wewe, last week tulikuwa na mtu mwingine. You know, you are part of this family.
Yeah, exactly.
Na hii kitu lazima tunyoroshe pamoja. Mm-hmm. Kama K, kama Kawa. And today, Mr. Prince.
Yep.
Nataka tuongelele kitu moja ito social media. And social. I like to call it the social media era.
Mm-hmm.
That's where we are.
Exactly.
Social media era. What do you understand when the term social media is mentioned? Wewe ni nini na kukujia kwa ya kwanza kwa mawazo?
You are right. Mm-hmm. We in a generation.
Yes.
And this generation, mm-hmm. so many things are changing. The world is growing exactly. Very, very fast and moving
rapidly. Yes.
And one of the things that I've noted, mm-hmm. is that the coming up of these platforms, the social media platforms.
Yes.
Basically, the website, the applications that are going to deal with the information, passage of information from one point to another, has seriously changed.
Yes.
And when you talk about social media, mm-hmm. that is the area that we want to venture on.
Yes. Mm. And today, mtu wangu, sijui wewe nikisema, what do you understand by social media? To me, I understand it as social media is an entity, or rather a platform, that makes the world ama the globe a common village.
Mm-hmm.
Inafanya dunia mzima ikuwe geshagi, as we can call it. And in this festive season, I know we are home, maybe others are not at work anymore, tuko nyumbani sisi wote, and you'll want to interact with your friends out there. Uh-huh. You'll want to have a rapport with your colleagues, with people you met in high school, you are no longer with them, you know? And social media has enabled us to do this. That I can know Prince, kama sasa venya tuko anawe last week, lakini tumeongea.
Yeah, exactly.
Tuliongea through WhatsApp, and WhatsApp is a social media communication channel or a platform.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I want us to define it pole pole.
Mm-hmm.
Najua mtazamaji anauliza, okay, Big Ed na Prince, where are you going with this?
Mm-hmm.
We know social media is good. We know its advantages and disadvantages. Nah. And today we want just to talk. Not many people talk about the social media today.
Mm-hmm.
And with this epidemic that we have been in, watu kufungiwa ndani, watu mekuwa in social media.
Yeah.
Kwa internet, websites, jobs, applications, all those, they are classified under social media. Now to you, Mr. Prince, how will you break it down maybe to our viewers and to our listeners?
We are getting into a sensitive and a very nice topic,
yes,
for that matter.
Yes.
Because as we talk to the young people, mm-hmm. we are on a platform, mm-hmm. that will help our young people,
yes.
to be able to connect with their friends,
yes.
to be able to connect with their families, mm-hmm. to be able to connect those who are in business,
yes.
to be able to connect with
to
their
market.
Colleagues. So this is basically a platform,
yes.
that is going to help people, mm-hmm. All as speedy, that is going to provide a very speedy call, communication,
yes. Yes.
whereby these kind of people, especially in our country and some of the countries around,
mm-hmm.
we have come to realize that with the growth of the ICT, the information technology, communication technology,
yeah, exactly, yeah.
The most or the most the one of the areas that mm-hmm. has been or that has accommodated the biggest population,
yes,
amongst the young people,
yes,
is the social media,
yes.
And we have learned that this is one of the areas. Okay, it may have a number of disadvantages,
yes,
it may have a number of advantages, yes, disadvantages,
just to cut you short, Kidogo,
yeah.
When we say social media has mm. accommodated a number of mm. young people in yeah. this generation today, maybe we can maybe highlight a number mm. where the young people have dwelled in or yeah. they have ventured in, because not all platforms.
Exactly.
You know?
I get you. Mm-hmm. For example, one of the most... in terms of the social media platforms, uh-huh. one of the areas where we have the highest and the biggest number of the population of the young people mm-hmm. is the Facebook,
yes,
which is slowly being overtaken by others like the Instagram.
The Instagram.
We have the Snapchat,
yeah,
the Twitter,
yeah,
and others. The mm-hmm. WhatsApp, where we have
where
quite
we,
a big if, population of the young people.
Yeah.
That have gotten in there.
Mm-hmm.
And it is actually people are getting more innovative. People,
yes,
are getting more, they want to learn more.
Yes.
People, they want to engage more.
Yes.
People want to socialize more. And that's mm-hmm. why we are calling them the social media platform.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
as much as they want to socialize more,
mm-hmm.
it has created more platforms. And mm-hmm. more are still coming. There are,
yeah,
so many.
True.
Other TikTok, Ikondani.
TikTok, Ikondani. You know, back in our days, even uh-huh. if I just take these a little back, we used to have to go. Wajua kuna ile msisi tu, hiyo nilikuanga niko huko vibaya sana. Back in the days, to go was the day of the was the communication of the norm.
Mm-hmm.
But you see, with time, it has been eradicated, ama it has run out.
Yeah.
It is no longer irrelevant. Hata kuna mtu anajua like, to go, what mm-hmm. is to go?
Mm-hmm.
Eh? But ilikuanga tunaitumia kwa zile simu za kabambe.
Yeah.
Vizuri sana.
Days are changing.
And now there's WhatsApp. Kuja imechukua by storm.
Things are changing every day with mm-hmm. the growth in the technology.
Yes.
And as much as people are still learning, people,
yes,
are still doing out things
mm-hmm.
out there.
Mm-hmm.
There are so many things that are being innovated and that are coming up,
yes,
every day.
Yes.
And that's why we must learn how mm-hmm. to accommodate them.
How to manage them.
Yeah, yeah.
Actually,
yeah, exactly.
One thing I can say to our viewers and our listeners that mm-hmm. social media should be managed.
Mm-hmm. That is the point, because with our young people,
mm-hmm.
what we need to understand
mm-hmm.
is that we are very good at receiving something that is new, something,
yes,
that helps us to connect with friends,
yes,
something that helps us to connect with our family. We mm-hmm. are very good at rushing and getting,
yes,
into it.
Yes.
So we need to address and talk mm-hmm. to our young people
mm-hmm.
and tell them what is why it is important to be able to do some of these things with moderation.
And as we dive into that topic, what are the impacts, or rather we can maybe classify impacts of social media in our generation today? How can we maybe classify it, maybe in a negative or in a positive manner, but in the society today, what are the impacts of social media?
One of the things that we need to understand,
yes,
is that everything, as I said, has advantages and disadvantages.
And disadvantages of it, yeah,
and
so,
the social media, mm-hmm. on the social media platforms,
mm-hmm.
what we need to understand is that it has more the advantages outweigh the disadvantages. So that's why as we talk about it,
mm-hmm.
we may talk about some of the negatives,
yes,
effect that we are going to get from,
yes,
the same,
yes,
but it still has some more positives. And that's why we need to look, as we are talking about the impact, because it has a number of impact in our society,
yes,
and amongst the young people,
yes,
we need to check on what should be avoided.
Yes.
What because if the question is social media good or bad?
Yeah.
And I would say it is good and bad.
Bad at the same,
so
same
at
time.
The same time.
Yeah.
Because it depends with how the person is going to receive the whole thing,
mm-hmm.
how the person is going to behave,
yes,
as far as mm-hmm. relating on social media is
concerned. Exactly.
What do you get from your Facebook? What mm-hmm. do you go for on WhatsApp?
Yes. Yes.
What do you do on your Twitter account?
On your Instagram.
Your Instagram.
What do you love?
What do you post?
What do you like?
What,
yeah,
do you study? What,
yeah,
do you read? Because,
uh-huh,
some of these areas,
mm-hmm.
most of them, as as we are saying that they have advantages that outweigh the disadvantages.
Yes.
And if you are keen on the advantages, then they are going to build us. They are going to help us.
Wow.
They are going to change our lives.
Beautiful.
And they are going to, you know, to help us in some of the areas that we need. Because basically the people that are usually create them or are coming up with these ideas, they are doing it to be able to help us.
Yeah,
and,
to make things easier.
Things move faster. Uh-huh. I like what you're saying about making the world a global village. You know, you can be able to connect, you can be able to communicate with people from very far. You can be able to do
sell
things,
even products,
business from very far, which was not
true.
Possible
before. Back in the days,
it was not easy to do that. But nowadays, you find that those things are just easy. You can do your business.
True.
You can be able to communicate. You can connect with friends that probably you are in school with for so many years ago.
You
can still be able to connect with them.
Uh-huh.
So we usually we need to understand that everything about the social media
is
that there is so much good that we need to get out of this, and other than taking more time on the negatives, on the things that we ought to, that we are likely to get from the social media platforms.
Before we go to the good of the social media, and the positive impact on social media in our generation today, why don't we just look some few negative things about this social media? Because as we have said, there's a good part of it and there's a bad part of it. So,
exactly.
And I know the good part of social media outweighs the negative part of it, you know. And I would want us to educate our viewers and our listeners, even in this time of a Christmas festive season that we are going into.
Yeah.
What are the things that we need to avoid? Ama, how can we positively use the social media, whereas we are looking at the negative aspect of it?
One of the things that we need to understand, we may talk about there we may have 101 negative things, but probably we may highlight a number of them.
Yes.
And some of the things that we need to understand, or one of the leading issues that we have experienced over the social media platforms, is the cyberbullying.
Cyberbullying.
The cyberbullying.
That's a very heated one.
Cyberbullying, a very heated one.
Uh-huh.
You see, because one of the things that you realize with what happens on social media, because people, you are not connecting with somebody one-on-one. You're not facing, that is eye to eye, or rather face to face. You have, people have the freedom, you know, to abuse. People have the freedom to threaten. People have the freedom, you know, to do any other, intimidate, you know, this kind of thing. People can expose you
threaten
on social
even.
Media. They can threaten you. They will do all manner of things. And one of the things that you realize, this is not happening with our own generation. It is something that is taking part within our young people, our young generation.
Whenever
you find that if I've got an issue with you,
with you,
I address you on Facebook. Yes,
nagurusha
mistari pale. Kama huko na deni yangu ninakuitishia pale. And I have over like for example
2000 and I tag you.
Ninakutagi pale.
Eh,
nasema endu jifunze kulipa deni. You see, those kind of, and I may end up tarnishing your image. I may end up, you know, and destroying everything, even your reputation through this kind of thing. So we need to, our young people are to understand that that is something that usually is happening with our young people, that we have to check on, that we have to control, that we have to understand that there is always a better way of doing these things. Because the moment somebody is involved in these some of these kind of things, this is where we have people are getting involved. People are getting into depression.
Mutu
mumekosana anakuandress
kwa
na anakutanga na anataka mabeshte zako.
So huyu jamaa mnamuonanga.
Mnamuonanga tu amumjui.
Amumjui ni.
Na wewe sasa kuna mahali mlikuwa mmepigwa tu picha na yeye. So anamwaga pale.
Anamwaga pale.
Ndio watu wajue. Ndio huyu sasa. Mnasemanga ni mheshimiwa, ati mkurugenzi.
Wa wapi?
Anaani unaanikwa.
Nimekataa. So how can we tell our viewers pale nje, because one thing I know that particular maybe Facebook, if I may say, or WhatsApp or Instagram or Twitter, the creator who created it, ama the one who developed that particular app, that was not his intention. His intention was to pass information, was to create communication, but now we are using it as a tool to attack our fellow brothers and sisters.
And to our young people, one of the things I would want them to understand is that the people that usually come up with these platforms, they are in business.
Yeah, business.
That's number one.
Yes.
So this person is in business.
Yes.
The more we are getting into Facebook, the more we are getting into Snapchat, the more we are getting into Twitter, there are people that are out there making money. And a lot of money for that matter.
Yeah.
So one of the things that you need to understand, ukiendelea kuokoa bandos, kuna mwingine pandeli ako kazi, unaona, anatengeneza pesa. So one of the things that we need to understand is that the moment we are getting into some of these areas, social media platforms, we need to check that some of the things that we are doing, let us not download our morals, let us not expose ourselves so much through the social media.
Yes.
Then one of the other things that I also like to talk to our young people, and they also need to understand is that hakuna mtu uchapa kwa social media.
Ni kweli.
Kila mtu wako ha
the best.
The best.
Ndio nadunga baba.
Hata ya kuomba si nini?
Hata kama una niokolea ka jacket kwanza ninyoroshwe picha.
Hata kama una gari, ma selfie, pigwa na mafi.
Kwanza nikiwa pale na mlango imefunguliwa. I'm driving na mlango imefunguliwa.
Umeomoka. And people are out there struggling to be like Eddie, failing to understand that this is, you know, this is just a publicity. People are out there, you know, to expose. Hakuna mtu ati ndoa yake ni mbaya kwa nini kwa Facebook. Hakuna. Iko perfect.
Uko beach.
Mnainuana. Unabebana.
Umepiga mtu busu.
Sasa hiyo kimeumana. Kuna chakula kwa nyumba.
Amuongeleshani.
Amuongeleshani.
Nalala huko, nalala huko.
So there's a lot of misinformation.
Yes.
There's a lot of wrong and banned information that is usually spread through the social media. That we also need our young people to understand. That you understand that when you have an issue, it is always, actually, even in terms of managing depression, it is better to meet a person one-on-one. Just talk to them.
Mwambie prince bana, uko na deni
yangu. Siku njianika kwa nini.
Uko na deni yangu bana. Siku njianika kwa nataka namna gani. We talk one-on-one.
Exactly.
We develop this particular cult. Hasa, kuna mutu, the first thing you wake up in the morning, ni kukonfirm. Hata kabla ukonfirm kama unaona. Kabla ukonfirm kama unafungua macho. Ni kwanza kuwasha data.
Unawakisha data pale. Hata
Before
uwakishe stima. Unaanza na data kwanza.
Unaanza na data. Before, if you are married or anything, or your wife, before she goes to the kitchen and maybe does some breakfast, kwanza kitu ya kwanza, before awashe moto, anawasha data.
Anawakisha data kwanza.
This is the hii natuonesha kwamba the social media, or the social culture, is we are being enslaved into this particular culture. And how can we, because watu wanasema siju social media, watu wanaongelea it's bad, but people are being addicted to social media. I remember there's a time, an year in my life, nearly withdraw from all the social platforms for like a good duration of time. I felt like, you know, I'm not living. Ni kama siishi. Ai, siko Facebook, siko WhatsApp, siko Instagram. I'm just living with people hapa kwa hapa. Ulikuwa unanitafuta, nilikutumia message WhatsApp. Haujaona? Nipigie simu ama tupatane one on one.
Yeah.
You know, I would wish we go back to such a place whereby we can have an intimate relationship or rather a conversation with you and resolve our conflicts.
Yeah.
We have said about negative side of social media, and yet they are there.
Just
there are
there.
A lot, there are many.
Exactly.
And because of time, we cannot go deep into them. Let us talk about the positive, where I want us to dwell more, because I know there is much we can do with social media, or rather these platforms that have been created to inform and to equip us. What will you say about that particular...
You started by talking about what our young people are doing and waking up in the morning, sleeping very late on social media. But at the end of the day, I like and want us to understand that it is very important to check how you manage your addictions. That is everything that carries everything about you. You need to check how you manage it. So, for example, if you are on social media, learn to plan yourself. Yes. Learn to plan your time. Learn to organize. Yeah.
Yeah.
Learn to organize yourself. That mm-hmm. this is what I want to do on this area. For mm-hmm. example, you will find young people, especially our young people. Mm-hmm. Somebody is in over 15 groups, WhatsApp groups. But these groups, there is nothing that is being done on those
Even
areas.
On Facebook.
On Facebook. It's mm-hmm. just chatting and sharing with friends. And mm-hmm. these are people that you are spending money. You are spending time.
Yeah.
We need to organize that if we are not careful on our time management, especially on social media platforms, then our young people, we are going to miss out on so many other things.
Very correct.
So we need to understand that mm-hmm. some of these social media mm-hmm. platforms, mm-hmm. they usually have a speed communication.
Yes.
But now I usually talk of organize yourself. What do I want to do on WhatsApp?
Yes.
What do I want to do on
Facebook?
On Facebook. What do I want to do on Instagram?
On Twitter.
Sio kuamuka unaenda TRM kupigwa picha ya kupost, unalipa fare unaenda TRM kupigwa picha ya kupost kwa Instagram. You know these kind
upate
of things.
Upate likes na followers.
Upate likes na followers. Ukipost ka picha after every 5 minutes unaangalia
ni wangapi wame like.
We need to understand that most of the people and mm-hmm. a good percentage of the people that know what is happening, they get on some of these social media platforms for mm-hmm. business, because mm-hmm. it is it provides a speed communication.
Yeah.
So when somebody gets on WhatsApp, they mm-hmm. are on WhatsApp for business.
Yes.
When they get on Facebook, they are on Facebook for, even if it's chatting, socializing,
mm-hmm.
limit time to socialize.
Limit
you don't,
time.
Mambo ya likes, mambo ya watu wana comment, na kukuchocha, una umepiga picture na ni marafiki zako.
Anakuambia,
hey, cute, hey.
Kitu,
you know, na hakuna kitu bwana. Na hata wezi kurushia kakitu.
Wow.
Na ukua bandos.
Na umeokoa bandos.
Umeokoa bandos.
So another maybe positive, those are negative sides mm-hmm. of the social media.
Yeah, yeah.
But I want us to look at some of the few positive things mm-hmm. that social media has brought in life. Like, for instance, I can jump in with like an educational platform.
Yeah.
Right now, with all this corona and lockdowns and all that, our children are not going to school. Universities have been closed. Mm-hmm. But the universities and the schools have opened a platform, or rather a podcast, whereby they can continue schooling and education.
Yeah.
You see, that's one positivity I would highlight.
Over this season, actually, personally as a teacher,
yes,
I have come to realize that the social media mm-hmm. has really been of very much great help,
mm-hmm.
because the moment you know the teachers, the parent, and the pupils, or the learners,
mm-hmm.
they disconnected.
Yes.
It was abrupt. It was not planned.
Yes.
But now, because of the social media, mm-hmm. that is social media, schools were able to connect with their learners.
Yeah.
That is, they were able to connect.
Yeah.
They were able to learn.
Yeah.
There are schools actually mm-hmm. that have been able to use some of these platforms. You talk of things like the Zoom.
Yes.
That have been able to use them to be able to stand it.
Yeah.
It has helped quite much.
Yeah.
And that's why to our parents mm-hmm. out there mm-hmm. that are even watching us, we need them to understand
mm-hmm.
that before you engage into, or you let your young ones, your children, engage into so many other places and do other bad things. Let them engage in some of these academic platforms.
Online libraries.
Online libraries.
So that good things online, actually.
Yeah, where they can be able to download some good materials. We cannot also... I said we cannot ignore mm-hmm. what is happening on our website.
Yes.
Let even the young people understand that there are so many and very nice stuff that we can be able to download from the website, especially those that are in school.
Mm-hmm.
As one. Then we have people that are in business.
Yes.
You have your business.
Yes.
Take your business online.
Wow. Yeah.
Instead of taking all
that is
the time.
It's taking it to the world now.
Yeah, it's taking it to
you're
the world.
You're opening it to the global
you're opening
market.
That one, you realize that probably the number of customers that you're getting per day could be 100 to 500.
Yes.
But if you are
introduce
you get some
online business
you're going to get or to access so many more customers you realize that because business is going to another level where now people are expecting everything served at their doorstep. It will be very easy to do it online. So even those that are in business, they need to understand that
online
bwana
mitandao. Another advantage of maybe of social media,
we are in church.
Yes,
Kanisa. We are in church. Yeah?
Yes. Bwana asifiwe. Hallelujah. Pastor, Bwana asifiwe. Amen.
Hii mambo ya kazi kushinda hapa unaenda kule tu rivers sijui wapi kupiga mapicha kupost. Angushia watu kamustari. But you are in Jiri.
Yeah.
Eh? Ingia live. Kwanza siku hizi Facebook baka unaingia live, YouTube. Post those kind of things whereby at least you are beneficial to the community.
And you are defying the body of Christ.
Yeah, exactly. Wow. Because people that are in church, these are church. Nice. You see, these are church. Hata kama hamuna page, hata mjaingia YouTube.
Yes. Tumia yako.
Ingia pale. Wewe ingia hapo.
Even another thing I can say, maybe I can recommend young people, if you want to do a case study, I'm a Bible study and all that, attract some few people and be like, you know what, see, to join group, to discuss mambo ya Biblia or something like that, something good that will edify, will make your knowledge go a notch higher. Yes, sir.
Yeah, na wale pia wako nini, wako single pale ya wajapatikana.
Wow, jifungulia huko ndani.
Tu pia huko. Bora musiiwe ni, unajua hii mambo ya social media bwana. Watu wanakuja wanakatiana, wanapendana. Hata harusi inafanywa online, inaishia huko. Na wana divorce tu huko, sasa hiyo ndio maneno sasa unapata vijana sasa. Yuzi, kama mmejuana, panga neni
kutane wano. Face to face is very key. At least kio mtu anakana mna gani.
It's very key. Exactly.
So we have seen the demerits, the advantages and the disadvantages of social media.
Yeah.
And as we conclude our topic today, what is your parting shot to our viewers out there? You can angalia camera.
Okay, my great advice to our young people is that I request our young people to go more for the virtues on social media than the vices.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, it's your parting shot. But when you say vices and virtues, what do you say?
Let us get on social media to get the very best. Yeah. Let us expose the positive. Let us do the right things on social media. Mm-hmm. Let us not use it as a weapon to attack people, as a threat, as intimidations and the rest. Let's do it for the best, and that is the best that we can do as young people.
This has been Dialogue at the Well, always at 6 p.m. Saturday, East African and worldwide time. And one thing I can say about a social media platform, if allowed with you, my viewer, if we can communicate with you one-on-one, how much time do you use online? When you go online, why do you turn on your data? What do you gather on the social platform? Because also on the social media, you are going to interact with all kinds of people out there, people who post all manner of information. But I want you to be categorically clear, what are your principles? What are you doing to edify yourself as a person? Because whatever you take in, it's going to have an effect on you. So you can kind of watch on your input, because whatever you have an input on, you're going to have an output on. And also the other thing is, prioritize your time. Time is key. We all have the same time in this world, but how you define your time is very key. You know, you can use your time constructively. I'm not saying being online is not constructive, but if you're just on Facebook, on WhatsApp, on Twitter, just for the sake of normalcy, at times nasemanga social media is a platform where we all bring our gossips together, but we can use it for a good cause in our times and generation. And I know we are in the festive season, enjoying mbuzi, nyama, choma. And to us from Wema TV here at Dialogue at the Well, we want to wish you a good weekend. And as we come closer to Christmas, enjoy it with family. Don't do social media. Have a social physical talk. Till we meet again, it has been Dialogue at the Well. Kama Kei, kama Kawa, with your host, Big Ed. And remember to like all our social media platforms. We go by Wema Online TV on Instagram, on Facebook, and on YouTube. Click on that bell. Ring, ring, ring. Kwa heri ya kuonana.
Wema TV, the voice of hope.